All right, Kuxer says if it's less than, if it's 120 or less, he can play. Let's try and find a 120. Right, Manfield, US East. Let's see what we got. But yeah, we should. Kuxer actually lives in Italy, for those of you who don't know, which gets very bad ping to East compared to somewhere like the UK where I stay. Like, I can get as good as 75, 80 ping on US East, but the best that Kuxer can hope for is like over 100. So let's see what kind of ping they've got. Let's see. It says zero. That's pretty good. 120. Playable says Kux. We're ready to go. That's pretty hype. Good on Kux for just playing out the ping. Looks like Dapper this time. Sporting the rose, but it looks like he's got the default camera glitch, which is still around, so we'll see what Kuxer's doing. Kuxer told me that he's playing with some new camera settings, or a funny camera for him, so he wants to get feedback on it. So hopefully this is actually the camera that he's using. I'm pretty sure it is. We'll see. It's 130 ping against 80. That's pretty even. That's pretty even. And these guys, of course, extremely high-rated 1v1 players. I don't want to discredit Dapper at all if he does beat Kux, with Kux having this ping, because Kux has said it's playable. And, you know, Kux is a fantastic player. This is one of the best servers he'll get ping-wise, so he's more than ready. He'll be more than fine. The first big win that I heard of Dapper getting was actually when Marky Duda tried fiddling about with his DS4 tool, or is it DS something tool, back in the day. What a save by Kux, actually. He's actually, the fact that he put that behind himself is what opens up this shot right now, and he's not gonna miss that one. He kept that ball perfectly away from Dapper. But what I was gonna say is that Marky was fiddling about with some settings, and he was playing the Scarab, and he's like, yeah, it feels great, and then he went into 1v1s and he lost twice in a row to Dapper, and he was like, huh. So it was a bit of a combination of Dapper playing really well and Marky being a silly bean. That's really risky for Kuxer to go for that boost. Dapper punishing him as expected. As soon as that ball bounces like this hard off the wall, you know that there's going to be a super open shot for Dapper. So taking that wide line back to goal like we saw Kux do is definitely not recommended. Dapper didn't even hit that shot across the goal into the corner. He pretty much hit it in the middle of the net, but there was adequate speed. This is really smart by Dapper. He's doing this, he's dribbling the ball backwards to give himself space. Fake jump to try and make Kuxer expect a shot. Again, just trying to give himself space, making Kux back off because he's potentially afraid of a shot. All right, Kuxer going for a bit of a delayed flick on the back of an air dribble, and he gets punished because obviously that's a high skill, high risk play. So Dapper is gonna get a counter attack. Every time Kux misses this, Dapper's got an easy counter. So it's pretty risky for Kux to go for that. We've seen air dribbles from both players. That's actually, I don't think Kux meant to do that. He meant to front flip on kickoff, but he double jumps by accident. But he recovered exceptionally well, has to be said. Recovered exceptionally well. Dapper's shots have been really on point, actually. He's putting out a lot of threat. Kux is giving him respect because the shots have been pretty solid. Kux is giving Dapper a lot of space, so he's obviously not too afraid of Dapper's dribbling. But Dapper's doing a reasonable job. He actually, his last touch really screwed him up there because he meant to put that last touch slightly off target so that he could rip a shot across the goal. But Dapper ended up just hitting the ball straight towards the goal, which means that his angles that he can shoot at are quite limited. He's doing a great job of boost starving Kuxer 97 though. Oh, that's dangerous. I'm actually surprised Kux went up for that. The ball was so close to Dapper, but Kux really does trust himself with his aerials. Especially like 50-50s in the air, Kuxer is very confident in those. Good try by Dapper, but again, that's the danger of going for an all-in play, like an air dribble, or like something of a follow-up to a ground shot, is that when you miss it, you're gonna land horrendously inside the goal of your opponent. That's the second counter-attack goal of the game. No, the third counter-attack goal of the game, actually. The only not counter-attack goal was the time where Kux went for corner boost at ill-advised time, and it's happened again. Man, they were seeing repeat of the second goal for, or the first goal for Dapper. Kux, he should not be going for this corner boost. There's just no reason to commit that hard to the corner. So pretty much every goal this game coming off of a mistake, like overextending an attack or Dapper twice now, taking advantage of Kux's greed for boost. I imagine Kux will probably put that a tiny bit down to his camera settings, maybe fiddling a bit with his depth perception. But either way, he should know better. Oh, that's not a good play by Kux again. Dapper with a nice finish. Kux really should be positioning himself a little bit more reliably. He kind of backs up into an awkward space, means to front flip into the ball, but he gets on the wrong side of it. Looks like Dapper with the edge in game one. He's been winning most of the kickoffs, which is something that happens when you have the ping advantage. You're going to win a few more kickoffs. This is the first direct kickoff goal that Kuxer could really do not much about, though. There wasn't much Kux could do about that one, except hit the ball better on the initial connection. Oh, I forgot to turn on Twitch alerts and my chat again. Let me do that after this game. It's a pretty all-in move again by Dapper right there. He's been making quite a few moves that involve him landing in an extremely aggressive position, which usually leads to him conceding possession to Kux. Has Kux lost a series on my stream? No, he's not. He's actually 7-0, so this would be a first. Going for a little bit of a mind game there. I think Dapper just stole that boost as well, which is huge. He could probably just run down the clock from here. He's got so much space and the boost. Oh, never mind. He loses control of the ball. Right, let me turn on my chat real quick on my stream so that YouTube can see what's happening. And Twitch alerts is on as well. You're in a hotel room and don't know what food to order. Get pizza. Right, so the game's definitely not over yet. Two goals in just under a minute in 1v1 is not that out of the question. Oh my goodness. The jump scares are back. Saucy Pancake, thanks for the sub. Somebody else subbed while Twitch alerts is off, so sorry if I didn't say thank you. I appreciate all the subs, guys. Really does mean a lot. So Kuxer again, still not panicking, still not rushing. He knows that he's got some time to try and manufacture a goal. Now he needs to be aggressive. 30 seconds left. Needs a goal sooner rather than later so he can get a kickoff and a play on the roll. Yeah, I like that he's going for a well shot there because he needs to take risks at this point. Two down with such little time left, and again, very risky challenge, but that's what you have to do if you're losing by two with this much time left in the clock. It really is just a matter of, does Kux think he's going to get two chances to score? If the answer is no, all in. But good game. Kux are dropping a game to Dapper. Dapper is getting one kickoff goal, so well played by him to get a more solid connection on the ball using the Octane. And also, Kux here just not respecting Dapper's post-kickoff shots. Of course, when I say post, I mean the time, not the frame of the net. This time, Kux are a default camera glitch, so we'll watch from Dapper's eyes. .130 ping is terrible for 1v1. Well, 130 ping is rough, but it's definitely not unplayable by any stretch of the imagination. Oh, what a 50-50 by Dapper. He's showing some expertise in that regard. And he actually bumps Kuxer off the boost. And again, oh, I don't really like that touch. I liked where Dapper was going. He was dribbling the ball back into his half. He's kind of found himself in a little bit of a tight corner again. He had a chance to dribble it all the way back to his half, then turn. And Kux would have been completely, well, not completely, but mostly boost starved. Very nice well control by Dapper, though he's keeping it closer to him than his opponent. Another air dribble attempt. That one's slightly less all-in, though, because notice the ball kind of naturally clearing itself. Oh, what a shot by Dapper. Beautiful play. Kuxer just finding himself on the wrong side of another like challenge. Kux has been defending his wall a lot more than he's been defending his goal in this series than we're used to seeing him. Than we're used to seeing from him. Yeah, Dapper just playing the boost starve game fantastically well, and of course Kux is someone who's well known for loving his boost. He's definitely gone out of that playstyle in the recent past. He doesn't rely on boost anywhere near as much as he used to. but he's still, you know, he's still human, and it's very annoying when somebody's boost starving you. Dapper didn't get the demo, but he did get the tailgate. T-boning Cucks to the side. What a shot. Dapper's just being quicker around the field here. Yeah, Cucks might not have gotten that boost, but even if he did, Dapper's just so quick there to get that shot, and Cucks really could have saved that, but it wasn't an easy one, so we're looking at that one understandably. The kickoffs have been brutal. Cucks is getting ruined on the kickoffs this game, losing possession on nearly every single one of them. Top class goalkeeping, as you would expect from the Italian. Dapper's just so fast. Oh, beautiful. Backhand flick from Cucks. That's a really nice play. That's something that we see more from players who like to play the Batmobile and Dominus and breakout cars like that. They like use the back end as it comes over the top of the flip to go for that finish. Oh, that's a beautiful save by Cucks. He would not have had more than 12 or 20 boost there. So very well done. That's a good job by Dapper to defend his net here rather than go for the corner boost. Doesn't matter though, because he can't get the ball to the side. Cucks are just putting an awkward enough shot right there that Dapper can't save it away from the goal. If that ball goes another ball width to the right, Cucks can't score it. Kickoff goal opportunity here. Doesn't get the hardest shot, but it's still unsavable. Cucks are just going to have to find a way to adapt to these high ping kickoffs. It is possible. He just has to remember that there is that slight input delay because of the ping. What you see on your screen is not necessarily what the server sees when you do have ping in the hundreds. Well, that's a reasonable attempt by Cucks. Good control of his car to, you know, get back down after that dodge. Very good corner defense by Dapper though. He's not phased, even though Cucks has taken literally every boost. Oh, is Cucks going to go for a demo or a flick? I think either one wouldn't have worked because Dapper actually managed to save enough boost. Power slide is ineffective for Cucks as well. That's a bit of a risky play by Dapper. He does recover very quickly. Well done by Dapper. Dapper extremely aware of when the threat is looming. He's actually defended his net to the open shots a lot better than Cucks has, and he's opting for a ball carry. This is actually something he's not been heavily reliant on. Just unreal goalkeeping by Cucks though. Something that we used to see from Scrub is getting across the net so quickly. Oh, that's not the clear Dapper was looking for. The constant pressure does get to the young American. That hit off the ceiling is what really did Dapper in. As soon as it hit off the ceiling and it bounced out and still kept its momentum sideways, very, very difficult to deal with, but Dapper really had to jump off the wall for that one, because anything that falls in front of the net, Cucks is going to finish. And speaking of anything that falls in front of the net, that's a really nice kickoff goal by Dapper. Very well placed in the top right. Oh my goodness, he didn't even have to put it in the top right. Cucks was so wide on this line. So very well played by Dapper once again. I think we're definitely going to see a rematch of this 1v1. At the next LAN, should both of these guys be there. I certainly hope that they are, and as competitors. Dapper's team, of course, doing exceptionally well in recent days in America. Momentum, almost full PS4 team, alongside JNaps, and I've forgotten the name of the third player. Somebody in chat remind me. It begins with M. Dapper going for a delayed flick, catches Cucks off guard. Cucks is being a little bit aggressive towards the end of this game. He knows that chances have been few and far between because Dapper has been winning most of the kickoffs, so Cucks has to take his opportunities every time he gets them. Very similar game to last. Mijo is the name of Dapper's other teammate. Mijo, JNaps, and Dapper, they've been doing a great job against the more well-known names like Kings of Urban, IBP, Exodus, Genesis, Mocket. Been doing really well. This is so all in by Dapper. That should be a goal for Cucks if he plays his cards right. Get it. And it is. Really no need for Dapper to go for this sort of play when he has the lead. Mijo. I said it wrong. Sorry guys. Not Mijo. Mijo. Okay, thank you. Thank you Twitch for keeping me right. Oh my goodness, Kuxer nearly winning a kickoff, but the ball going to Dapper's side, because he did indeed flip through it. Oh, Dapper with a misplay, not checking out the Kux's whereabouts. He expected Kux to be later on his arrival, but Kux has actually just been going supersonic pretty much the whole way, knocking it in right as soon as it's shootable. 5-all. I really do want this to go to game 3. I did say best of 3 to these guys, but I'd love to see them play a third time. Regardless, very interesting matchup. Oh my goodness, that turn by Kux was actually not ideal. Notice how his car was pretty much sideways as he jumped. That's not going to be a goal either. Zapper's doing fantastically well. Kux are not half-flipping. Definitely needs to check out my tutorial on half-flipping. Well, that's very all-in by Dapper again. Kuxer could have played his car better there and gotten a goal. Again, misplay by Dapper. That was a shot chance for Kux, but he just took too long. Kux definitely not playing as confidently as we're used to seeing him play. Oh my goodness, Dapper's on the wrong side of the ball. Oh, this could be it. Can Kux keep it up? That's not an easy one. He does it! Kuxer with the keep up at the end. What a shot. This is not at all easy. Getting the flick and then this touch is what really made this possible. That's just a beautiful first touch right there. Beautifully done. I really wanted to see that just for the, you know, the third game, and also because that was, you know, 0 second goal. Oh my. And we get to see the Kuxer celebration. What a finish. Just incredible stuff from the Italian. So game 3, here we go. Kuxer coming back from 2-down, doing exactly what he couldn't do in the first game. Looks like we'll be in Dapper's perspective for the most part of this game again, because Kuxer with the default camera glitch. Wow. That's all I could say. Wow. Never count out Kuxer. 130 ping, he doesn't care. 0 seconds, this man doesn't care. But Dapper, though, some exceptional aerial mechanics off the wall and up extremely quickly. Kux should really be winning that, though. I don't know why Kux was so slow to that ball. How many games are they doing? This will be the last game in this matchup. I like to do best of threes just to give other people a chance to come on and show their stuff. Very nice delayed flick. You can't defend reactively from that range if you are a Kuxer. He kind of just has to, I feel he has to throw himself at that ball, because if you let Dapper get that close, there's no way you're saving a top corner shot from that range. And Dapper's already shown that he's very capable of flicking the ball at will. Like I've said so before in my stream, if you're playing the Octane and you want to get better at those types of flicks, just air roll slightly towards the ball before you front flip or diagonal flip. That'll help you make the contact. Kuxer, a little bit of a misplay there, driving under the ball, but he keeps it bouncing, which is key, because then you can go for a flip or a shot or a fake. Your options are really a lot more varied if you can keep the ball bouncing. I'd be very surprised if Dapper jumped off that wall. He's kind of given away possession. Oh my god, how did... What? Excuse me? Where did the power come from on this wall clear? We're not going to see it. That touch was iron... What? I'm so confused. I don't know what to say. That touch, I don't even know how it happened. Kuxer just pinching the ball with the wall. I think what happened is he hit it right at the same time as it bounced off the wall, and it just, like, bounces downfield. I mean, we saw Dapper wasn't ready for that at all. He just got completely taken out of the game by a touch that really did not look possible. Save replay? I don't even know what that was. Kux hacking. Feels Batman. Kuxer actually playing extremely passively. He actually had a chance to take Dapper out the game there. And not the greatest flick by Kux. I feel like Kux could slow down on his flicks just a little bit, because sometimes he just double taps that jump button as quickly as he can and his car flips underneath the ball. If he just delays that flip a tiny little bit, air rolls forwards towards the ball, even with a long car, the same principle applies. You're more likely to get the hit. This is clever play by Kux. He's actually picked up 2 boost pads here, so he's not starved. Knocks it up the wall to kill time. Goes for a fake, though. Okay, it's actually played out relatively well into Kux's favor. He's got the boost that he needed, but he is under pressure now. Yeah, Kux definitely has had a few chances to be aggressive and take the game to Dapper, but he's afraid to move forward Mostly because Dapper's challenges have been very on point. Very on point. And he has been the more aggressive of the two players. Oh, sneaky. Both players go into the other half to get the boost. Dapper should have this. Well done by Dapper. Very well done. So dangerous for Kux to give him the space here. Because if we know that Dapper's got a good first touch, which he clearly does, and a very nice air roll to boot, then that's going to give him the 3-goal lead. We do know Kux is able to mind a comeback, but he's going to have to start hitting his kickoffs a lot more cleanly. I don't know why Dapper's still playing right into Kux's hands with these cross... Oh, that's a good save. But like I was saying, Dapper's kind of playing right into Kux's hands with the cross-goal shots. And just as we say that about Dapper, Kux does the same thing. Trying to rush the ball into the goal. There's only two mindsets that you have in one versus one. One, you think your opponent's going to be there to save your shot, so you don't rush. Two, you think your opponent isn't going to be there, so you do rush. It's either you think the net's open or it's defended. There's no in-between. And with what we're seeing from these players, they're kind of making shots at the net as if it weren't defended, but we can see that clearly it is. Kind of surprised that Dapper didn't take this corner boost, because now he's lost his chance to just starve the entire right side. Again, early challenge by Dapper. Kux really didn't adapt his attack strategy enough this game. If Kux wants to outplay this early challenge, he has to make one touch and then a second touch immediately afterwards to flick it over Dapper. But to do that, you have to get the read on Dapper's challenging, which is not what we saw right there. Kux are expecting Dapper to back off, and Dapper is like, nah, I'm just going to challenge you. Kickoff goal for Kux, though. Could be the start of a comeback. It's 4 goals in just over a minute and a half. Definitely possible. But we'll see if Kux can start the momentum in his favor. That's a reasonable start for Kux. Is he going to come out of this with possession, though? Looks like the answer is no. Again, Dapper with the same defensive strategy. As soon as Kux makes a play, Dapper rushes him. And I don't know why Kux is still expecting Dapper to back off. Because Dapper's been playing this very, very consistently. He's been, you know, being aggressive and rushing the ball the vast majority of the time. It's pretty much like if he has boost, then he rushes. If he doesn't have boost, then he backs off. That's been the flowchart of Dapper's defensive strategy, as far as I can see. And it's, you know, it's easier for me to see that from a spectator point of view, because I don't have to be thinking about the game and the mechanics. And I'm not up till ridiculous o'clock. I'm up till ridiculous o'clock minus 1 hour. But that should be it for Kux. It's going to be super difficult. Should be super difficult for Kux to get even a goal back at this point. It doesn't look like Dapper is going to give him anything. Very well played by Dapper. The Afro man. Dapper's got an Afro, for those of you who don't know. Do people really think that Dapper could win if this were LAN ping? You know, absolutely. Dapper's offensive strategy has been outplaying Kux regardless of ping at certain times. And Dapper, we've seen him doing bounce shots, we've seen him carrying the ball, we've seen him, you know, doing a really, really solid kickoff. I'm expecting him to do Scrubs kickoff again. Okay, that's actually not Scrubs kickoff. Never mind. But I've seen, really solid kickoffs from Dapper, very solid offensive strategy, extremely aggressive defending, which is similar to players like Marky Duda, Mike Rules, and Pashi, other top level, usually Octane 1v1 players. So really, really well played by Dapper. Fantastic aggression. And Kux with a fantastic comeback in game 2. Not able to take down game 3. Greasy wanted to vs Kux. It is noteworthy, though, that it's extremely hard to do consistent challenges and kickoffs on 130 ping. Trust himself with his aerials, especially like 50-50s in the air. Kuxer is very confident in those. Good try by Dapper, but again, that's the danger of going for an all-in play, like an air dribble or like something of a follow-up to a ground shot, is that when you miss it, you're going to land horrendously inside the goal of your opponent. That's the second counter-attack goal of the game. No, the third counter-attack goal of the game, actually. The only not counter-attack goal was the time where Cucks went for corner boost at ill-advised time, and it's happened again. Man, they were seeing repeat of the second goal for, or the first goal for Dapper. Cucks, he should not be going for this corner boost. There's just no reason to commit that hard to the corner. So pretty much every goal this game coming off of a mistake, like overextending an attack or Dapper twice now, taking advantage of Cux's greed for boost. I imagine Cux will probably put that a tiny bit down to his camera settings, maybe fiddling a bit with his depth perception. But either way, he should know better. Oh, that's not a good play by Cux again. Dapper with a nice finish. Cux really should be positioning himself a little bit more reliably. He kind of backs up into an awkward space, means to front flip into the ball, but he gets on the wrong side of it. Looks like Dapper with the edge in game one. He's been winning most of the kickoffs, which is something that happens when you have the ping advantage. You're going to win a few more kickoffs. This is the first direct kickoff goal that Cuxer could really do not much about, though. There wasn't much Cux could do about that one, except hit the ball better on the initial connection. Oh, I forgot to turn on Twitch alerts and my chat again. Let me do that after this game. It's a pretty all-in move again by Dapper right there. He's been making quite a few moves that involve him landing in an extremely aggressive position, which usually leads to him conceding possession to Cux. Has Cux lost a series on my stream? No, he's not. He's actually 7-0, so this would be a first. Going for a little bit of a mind game there. I think Dapper just stole that boost as well, which is huge. He could probably just run down the clock from here. He's got so much space and the boost. Oh, never mind. He loses control of the ball. Right, let me turn on my chat real quick on my stream so that YouTube can see what's happening. And Twitch alerts is on as well. You're in a hotel room and don't know what food to order. Get pizza. Right, so the game's definitely not over yet. Two goals in just under a minute in 1v1 is not that out of the question. Oh my goodness. The jump scares are back. Saucy Pancake, thanks for the sub. Somebody else subbed 12. Twitch alerts is off, so sorry if I didn't say thank you. I appreciate all the subs, guys. Really does mean a lot. So Cuxer again, still not panicking, still not rushing. He knows that he's got some time to try and manufacture a goal. Now he needs to be aggressive. 30 seconds left. Needs a goal sooner rather than later so you can get a kickoff and a play on the roll. Yeah, I like that he's going for a well shot there because he needs to take risks at this point. Two down with such little time left, and again, very risky challenge, but that's what you have to do if you're losing by two with this much time left in the clock. It really is just a matter of, does Cux think he's going to get two chances to score? If the answer is no, all in. A good game. Cux are dropping a game to Dapper. Dapper is getting one kickoff goal, so well played by him to get a more solid connection on the ball using the Octane. And also, Cux are just not respecting Dapper's post-kickoff shots. Of course, when I say post, I mean the time, not the frame of the net. This time, Cux are default camera glitch, so we'll watch from Dapper's eyes. This man doesn't care. But Dapper, though, some exceptional aerial mechanics off the wall and up extremely quickly. Cux should really be winning that, though. I don't know why Cux was so slow to that ball. How many games are they doing? This will be the last game in this matchup. I like to do best of threes just to give other people a chance to come on and show their stuff. Very nice delayed flick. You can't defend reactively from that range if you are a Cuxer. He kind of just has to, I feel he has to throw himself at that ball, because if you let Dapper get that close, there's no way you're saving a top corner shot from that range. And Dapper's already shown that he's very capable of flicking the ball at will. Like I've said so before on my stream, if you're playing the Octane and you want to get better at those types of flicks, just air roll slightly towards the ball before you front flip or diagonal flip. That'll help you make the contact. Kuxer with a little bit of a misplay there, driving under the ball, but he keeps it bouncing, which is key, because then you can go for a flip or a shot or a fake. Your options are really a lot more varied if you can keep the ball bouncing. I'd be very surprised if Dapper jumped off that wall. He's kind of given away possession. Oh my god, how did... What? Excuse me? Where did the power come from on this wall clear? We're not going to see... That touch was iron... What? I'm so confused. I don't know what to say. That touch, I don't even know how it happened. Kuxer just pinching the ball with the wall. I think what happened is he hit it right at the same time as it bounced off the wall, and it just, like, bounces downfield. I mean, we saw Dapper wasn't ready for that at all. He just got completely taken out of the game by a touch that really did not look possible. Save replay? I don't even know what that was. Kux hacking. Feels Batman. Kux are actually playing extremely passively. He actually had a chance to take Dapper out of the game there. And not the greatest flick by Kux. I feel like Kux could slow down on his flicks just a little bit, because sometimes he just double taps that jump button as quickly as he can and his car flips underneath the ball. If he just delays that flip a tiny little bit, air rolls forwards towards the ball, even with a long car, the same principle applies. You're more likely to get the hit. This is clever play by Kux. He's actually picked up two boost pads here, so he's not starved. Knocks it up the wall to kill time. Goes for a fake though. Okay, it's actually played out relatively well into Kux's favor. He's got the boost that he needed, but he is under pressure now. Yeah, Kux definitely has had a few chances to be aggressive and take the game to Dapper, but he's afraid to move forward, mostly because Dapper's challenges have been very on point. Very on point, and he has been the more aggressive of the two players. Oh, sneaky. Both players go into the other half to get the boost. Dapper should have this. Well done by Dapper, very well done. So dangerous for Kux to give him the space here, because if we know that Dapper's got a good first touch, which he clearly does, and a very nice air roll to boot, then that's going to give him the 3-goal lead. We do know Kux is able to mount a comeback, but he's going to have to start hitting his kickoffs a lot more cleanly. I don't know why Dapper's still playing right into Kux's hands with these cross... Oh, that's a good save. But like I was saying, Dapper's kind of playing right into Kux's hands with the cross-goal shots. And just as we say that about Dapper, Kux does the same thing, trying to rush the ball into the goal. There's only two mindsets that you have in one versus one. One, you think your opponent's going to be there to save your shot, so you don't rush. Two, you think your opponent isn't going to be there, so you do rush. It's either you think the net's open or it's defended. There's no in-between. And with what we're seeing from these players, they're kind of making shots at the net as if it weren't defended, but we can see that clearly it is. That's a lot better than Kux has, and he's opting for a ball carry. This is actually something he's not been heavily reliant on. Just unreal goalkeeping by Kux, though. Something that we used to see from Scrub is getting across the net so quickly. Oh, that's not the clear Dapper was looking for. The constant pressure does get to the young American. That hit off the ceiling is what really did Dapper in. As soon as it hit off the ceiling and it bounced out and still kept its momentum sideways, very, very difficult to deal with, but Dapper really had to jump off the wall for that one, because anything that falls in front of the net, Kux is going to finish. And speaking of anything that falls in front of the net, that's a really nice kickoff goal by Dapper. Very well placed in the top right. Oh my goodness, he didn't even have to put it in the top right. Kux was so wide on this line. So very well played by Dapper once again. I think we're definitely going to see a rematch of this 1v1 at the next LAN, should both of these guys be there. I certainly hope that they are, and as competitors. Dapper's team, of course, doing exceptionally well in recent days in America. Momentum, almost full PS4 team, alongside JNaps, and I've forgotten the name of the third player. Somebody in chat remind me. It begins with M. Dapper going for a delayed flick, catches Kux off guard. Kux is being a little bit aggressive towards the end of this game. He knows that chances have been few and far between, because Dapper has been winning most of the kickoffs, so Kux has to take his opportunities every time he gets them. Very similar game to last. Mijo is the name of Dapper's other teammate. Mijo, JNaps, and Dapper, they've been doing a great job. against the more well-known names like Kings of Urban, IBP, Exodus, Genesis, Mocket. Be doing really well. This is so all in by Dapper. That should be a goal for Cux if he plays his cards right. Get it. And it is. Really no need for Dapper to go for this sort of play when he has the lead. Miho. I said it wrong. Sorry, guys. Not Mijo. Miho. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Twitch, for keeping me right. Oh my goodness, Cux are nearly winning a kickoff, but the ball going to Dapper's side because he did indeed flip through it. Oh! Dapper with a misplay, not checking out the Cux's whereabouts. He expected Cux to be later on his arrival, but Cux has actually just been going supersonic pretty much the whole way, knocking it in right as soon as it's shootable. 5-all. I really do want this to go to game 3. I did say best of 3 to these guys, but I'd love to see them play a third time. Regardless, very interesting matchup. Oh my goodness, that turn by Cux was actually not ideal. Notice how his car was pretty much sideways as he jumped. That's not going to be a goal either. Dapper's doing fantastically well. Cux are not half-flipping. Definitely needs to check out my tutorial on half-flipping. Well, that's very all-in by Dapper again. Cux are could have played his car better there and gotten a goal. Again, misplay by Dapper. That was a shot chance for Cux, but he just took too long. Cux definitely not playing as confidently as we're used to seeing him play. Oh my goodness, Dapper's on the wrong side of the ball. Oh, this could be it. Can Cux keep it up? That's not an easy one. He does it! Cux are with the keep up at the end. What a shot. This is not at all easy. Getting the flick and then this touch is what really made this possible. That's just a beautiful first touch right there. Beautifully done. I really wanted to see that just for the, you know, the third game, and also because that was, you know, 0 second goal. Oh my. And we get to see the Cuxer celebration. What a finish. Just incredible stuff from the Italian. So game 3, here we go. Cux are coming back from 2 down, doing exactly what he couldn't do in the first game. Looks like we'll be in Dapper's perspective for the most part of this game again, because Cux are with the default camera glitch. Wow. That's all I could say. Wow. Never count out Cux here. 130 ping, he doesn't care. 0 sec. 130 ping is terrible for 1v1. Well, 130 ping is rough, but it's definitely not unplayable by any stretch of the imagination. Oh, what a 50-50 by Dapper. He's showing some expertise in that regard. And he actually bumps Cuxer off the boost. And again, oh, I don't really like that touch. I liked where Dapper was going. He was dribbling the ball back into his half. He's kind of found himself in a little bit of a tight corner again. He had a chance to dribble it all the way back to his half, then turn. And Cux would have been completely, well, not completely, but mostly boost-starved. Very nice well control by Dapper, though he's keeping it closer to him than his opponent. Another air dribble attempt. That one's slightly less all-in, though, because notice the ball kind of naturally clearing itself. Oh, what a shot by Dapper. Beautiful play. Cux are just finding himself on the wrong side of another like challenge. Cux has been defending his wall a lot more than he's been defending his goal in this series than we're used to seeing him. Than we're used to seeing from him. Yeah, Dapper just playing the boost starve game fantastically well, and of course Cux is someone who's well known for loving his boost. He's definitely gone out of that playstyle in the recent past. He doesn't rely on boost anywhere near as much as he used to, but he's still, you know, he's still human, and it's very annoying when somebody's boost starving you. Dapper didn't get the demo, but he did get the tailgate, T-boning Cux to the side. What a shot. Dapper's just being quicker around the field here. He's just being quicker around the field. Yeah, Cux might not have gotten that boost, but even if he did, Dapper's just so quick there to get that shot, and Cux really could have saved that, but it wasn't an easy one, so we understandably, or we're looking at that one understandably. The kickoffs have been brutal. Cux is getting ruined on the kickoffs this game, losing possession on nearly every single one of them. Top class goalkeeping, as you would expect from the Italian. Dapper's just so fast. Oh, beautiful. Backhand flick from Cux. That's a really nice play. That's something that we see more from players who like to play the Batmobile and Dominus and breakout cars like that. They like use the back end as it comes over the top of the flip to go for that finish. Oh, that's a beautiful save by Cux. He would not have had more than 12 or 20 boost there. So very well done. That's a good job by Dapper to defend his net here rather than go for the corner boost. Doesn't matter though because he can't get the ball to the side. Cuxer just putting an awkward enough shot right there that Dapper can't save it away from the goal. If that ball goes another ball width to the right, Cux can't score it. Kickoff goal opportunity here. Doesn't get the hardest shot, but it's still unsavable. Cuxer's going to have to find a way to adapt to these high ping kickoffs. It is possible. He just has to remember that there's that slight input delay. Because of the ping, what you see on your screen is not necessarily what the server sees when you do have ping in the hundreds. Well, that's a reasonable attempt by Cux. Good control of his car to, you know, get back down after that dodge. Very good corner defense by Dapper, though. He's not phased, even though Cux has taken literally every boost. Oh, is Cux going to go for a demo or a flick? I think either one wouldn't have worked because Dapper actually managed to save enough boost. Power slide is ineffective for Cux as well. That's a bit of a risky play by Dapper. He does recover very quickly. Well done by Dapper. Dapper extremely aware of when the threat is looming. He's actually defended his net to the open shot. Alright, Cuxer says if it's less than, if it's 120 or less, he can play. Let's try and find a 120. Alright, Manfield, US East, let's see what we got. But yeah, we should... Cuxer actually lives in Italy, for those of you who don't know, which gets very, very bad ping to East compared to somewhere like the UK where I stay. Like, I can get as good as 75, 80 ping on US East, but the best that Cux can hope for is, like, over 100. So, let's see what kind of ping they've got. Let's see. It says 0. That's pretty good. 120. Playable, says Cux. We're ready to go. That's pretty hype. Good on Cux for just playing out the ping. Looks like Dapper this time, sporting the rose, but it looks like he's got the default camera glitch, which is still around, so we'll see what Cuxer's doing. Cuxer told me that he's playing with some new camera settings, or a funny camera for him, so he wants to get feedback on it. So hopefully this is actually the camera that he's using. I'm pretty sure it is. We'll see. It's 130 ping against 80, that's pretty even. That's pretty even. And these guys, of course, extremely high-rated 1v1 players. I don't want to discredit Dapper at all if he does beat Cux, with Cux having this ping, because Cux has said it's playable. And, you know, Cux is a fantastic player. This is one of the best servers he'll get ping-wise, so he's more than ready. He'll be more than fine. The first big win that I heard of Dapper getting was actually when Marky Duda tried fiddling about with his DS4 tool, or is it DS-something tool, back in the day. What a save by Cux, actually. He's actually... The fact that he put that behind himself is what opens up this shot right now, and he's not going to miss that one. He kept that ball perfectly away from Dapper. But what I was going to say is that Marky was fiddling about with some settings, and he was playing the Scarab, and he's like, yeah, it feels great. And then he went into 1v1s, and he lost twice in a row to Dapper, and he was like, huh. So it was a bit of a combination of Dapper playing really well and Marky being a silly bean. That's really risky for Cuxer to go for that boost. Dapper punishing him as expected. As soon as that ball bounces like this hard off the wall, you know that there's going to be a super open shot for Dapper. So taking that wide line back to goal like we saw Cux do is definitely not recommended. Dapper didn't even hit that shot across the goal into the corner. He pretty much hit it in the middle of the net, but there was adequate speed. This is really smart by Dapper. He's doing this, he's dribbling the ball backwards to give himself space. Fake jump to try and make Cuxer expect a shot. Again, just trying to give himself space, making Cux back off because he's potentially afraid of a shot. Alright, Cuxer going for a bit of a delayed flick on the back of an air dribble. And he gets punished because obviously that's a high skill, high risk play. So Dapper is going to get a counter attack. Every time Kux misses this, Dapper's got an easy counter. So it's pretty risky for Kux to go for that. We've seen air dribbles from both players. That's actually, I don't think Kux meant to do that. He meant to front flip on kickoff, but he double jumps by accident. But he recovered exceptionally well, has to be said. Recovered exceptionally well. Dapper's shots have been really on point, actually. He's putting out a lot of threat. Kux is giving him respect because the shots have been pretty solid. Kux is giving Dapper a lot of space, so he's obviously not too afraid of Dapper's dribbling. But Dapper's doing a reasonable job. He actually, his last touch really screwed him up there because he meant to put that last touch slightly off target so that he could rip a shot across the goal. But Dapper ended up just hitting the ball straight towards the goal, which means that his angles that he can shoot at are quite limited. He's doing a great job of boost-starving Kux through 97, though. Oh, that's dangerous. I'm actually surprised Kux went up for that. The ball was so close to Dapper, but Kux really does...